It's Women's History Month, and I'm here at the Swan House at the Atlanta History Center with Jessica Van Landyte. Now, women of color were also involved in the movement. This is Adela Hunt Logan.
Yes, she's a Tuskegee University professor, graduate of Atlanta University right here in Atlanta. What's really kind of important to note throughout the exhibition is that women are showing up in a bunch of different ways, and they're showing up for different causes or different reasons. And so you'd see women of color, you've got African American women, you've got Mexican American women, you have Chinese American women who may have in the state that they're living not have the right to vote, or know they may not realize the right to vote after the 19th Amendment's passed, but they're saying, we realize that the vote is important, we realize we need our voice, right? And so they're going to show up and they're going to campaign for equality, and also the fact that the vote gives them the power to do other things. They can support education initiatives, they can support whatever cause is best for them. So that's kind of a means to the end, is the vote for them.
Now, although the African American women were working in the movement, still, because of Jim Crow laws, it was very hard for them to get to vote. How much harder was it for women who were Asian, like the doctor you have?
Yeah, Dr. Mabel Lee is a Chinese American immigrant. She's living in New York. And that's kind of the tricky thing of voting rights, is it's really tied to citizenship, and Chinese Americans were not considered citizens at this point. So she is fighting for the right to vote, knowing that if it's passing, Mrs. Logan here, she realizes that she might not get to exercise it. It's not until the 1940s when Chinese Americans are granted citizenship, and then she would have been able to exercise her right to vote. And that's the same thing for Native American women or Mexican American women. It takes kind of additional amendments or movements in order to realize it.
How important is the woman population when it comes to voting now?
Oh, we're really important. It took a few years, but women, I think in 1980, equaled the amount of turnout for men, so proportionate to men since 1980, we have surpassed it. So the women's vote is the majority vote in this country. Importantly as well, is the second largest voting block is the 18 to 29. Those young folks have the second largest and quite a bit of power in exercising the vote.
So that means if more of them would turn out,
they could get more things done.
It's amazing. Well, we're going to take a look later at one woman who was involved in the movement, who has something to do with the Swan House and the development of another organization that is still in operation today.